I've given up.
Thanks. Have you got to be somewhere?
Work. I didn't fancy my sandwiches.
I don't eat fish.
Why not?
Fish piss in the sea.
So do children.
I don't eat children either. What's your work?
Well, I'm a sort of a journalist.
What sort?
I write obituaries.
Do you like it, the dying business?
It's a living.
Did you grow up in a graveyard?
Yeah, suburbia.
Do you think a doctor will come?
Eventually. But does it hurt?
I'll live.
Or shall I put your leg up?
Why?
That's what people do in these situations.
What is this situation?
Do you want me to put your leg up?
Yes, please.
Got your mobile. Is there anyone you'd like to phone?
I don't know anyone. Who cut off your crusts?
Me.
Did your mother used to cut off your crusts when you were a little boy?
I believe she did, yes.
You should eat your crusts.
You should stop smoking.
Thank you for scraping me off the road.
My pleasure.
Good night.
Are you damsel? Oh, why didn't you look?
I never look where I'm going.
Well, we stood at the lights. I looked into your eyes, and then you stepped into the road.
Then what?
Well, you were lying on the ground. You focused on me and you said, "Hello, stranger."
What a slut.
Well, I noticed your leg was cut.
Did you notice my legs?
Quite possibly.
Then what?
Well, when the cabbie got down, he crossed himself and said, "Thank fuck, I thought I killed her." I said, "Let's get her to the hospital." He hesitated. I think he thought there'd be paperwork, that he'd be held responsible. So I said with a slight sneer, "Please, just drop us at the hospital."
Show me the sneer. Very good, Buster.
Well, he put you in the cab and came here.
What was I doing?
Well, you were murmuring, "I'm very sorry for all the inconvenience." I had my arm around you and your head was on my shoulder.
Was my head lolling?
That's exactly what.
You'll be late for work.
Are you saying you want me to go?
I'm saying you'll be late for work.
Why are you at Blackfriars Bridge?
I've been to a club in the meat market, Smithfield. Do you have clubbing?
No, I'm too old.
How old are you?
35.
Half time?
Thank you very much. So you were clubbing?
And then I decided to go for a walk. I want to see the meat being unloaded.
Oh, the carcasses? Why?
Because they're impulsive. And then I went to this tiny park. It's a graveyard too, Postman's Park. Do you know it?
Yeah.
There's a memorial for ordinary people who died saving the lives of others. It's most curious. And then I decided to go to Borough, so I went to Blackfriars Bridge to cross the river.
That park? It's near here?
Yes.
Is there a statue?
A minotaur.
Ah, I do know it. We sat there. My mother's dead. My father and I sat there the afternoon she died. She died here, actually. She was a smoker. My father ate an egg sandwich. His hands trembled with grief. Pieces of egg fell on the grass and butter on his top lip. But I don't remember a memorial.
Is your father still alive?
No, clinging on. He's in a home.
How did you end up writing obituaries? What did you really want to be?
Oh. I had dreams of being a writer, but I had no voice. What am I saying? I had no talent. So I ended up in the Siberia of journalism.
Tell me what you do. I want to imagine you in Siberia.
Really?
Oh, yes.
Well, we call it the obits page. There's three of us, me, Harry, and Graham. And when I go to work each morning, without fail, Graham will say, "Who's on the slab?" Meaning, did anyone important die overnight? Are you sure you want to hear?
Yes.
Well, if someone important did die, then we go to the deep freeze. That's this computer that contains all the obituaries, and we find the dead person's life.
People's obituaries are written while they're still alive.
Some people's. If no one important has died, then Harry, he's the editor, he decides who we lead with, and then we make calls, check facts, polish the prose. Some days, I might be asked to deal with the widows or widowers. They try to persuade us to write obituaries for their husbands or wives. They feel we're dishonoring their memories if we don't, but, well, there just isn't space. I At six, we stand around the computer and read the next day's page and make final changes. Put in a few euphemisms for our amusement.
Such as?
He was a convivial fellow, meaning he was an alcoholic. He valued his privacy, gay. He enjoyed his privacy, raging queen.
And what would your euphemism be?
For me? Mm-hmm. He was reserved.
Am I?
She was disarmed.
How did you get this job?
Oh, they ask you to write your own obituary. If it amuses, you're in. Excuse me, we've been waiting quite a long time.
Sorry, it's not mine. What happened?
I was hit by a cab.
She was unconscious for about 10 seconds.
May I? You feel your toes?
Yes.
What's this?
It's a scar.
Yes, I know it's a scar. Where'd you get it?
An America truck.
It's an awful job.
I was in the middle of nowhere.
Well, you'll be fine.
Can I have one? A cigarette?
Don't smoke it here.
Thank you.
You want a drag?
Yes, but no. What were you doing in the middle of nowhere?
Traveling.
Alone?
With a male.
What happened to this man?
I don't know, I ran away.
Just like that?
It's the only way to leave. If you don't love him anymore, goodbye.
Suppose you do still love him?
Then you don't leave.
Oh, you mean you've never left someone you still love?
No.
Well, when did you get back?
Yesterday.
Where did you go?
York.
Where are your belongings?
I'm awake.
Did you like New York?
Sure.
Were you studying?
Stripping. Look at your little eyes.
I can't see my little eyes.
They're popping out. You're good too.
Were you good at it?
Exceptional.
Why?
Because I know what men want.
Really?
Oh, yes.
Tell me.
Men want a girl who looks like a boy. And they want to protect her, but she must be a survivor. And she must come like a train, but with elegance. What do you want?
Who was this male?
A customer, but once I was his, he hated stripping.
And what do you want?
To be loved.
That simple?
It's a big want. Do you have a girlfriend?
Yeah, Ruth. She's called Ruth. She's a linguist. Will you meet me after work?
No. Take the day off. Don't go and see who's on the slab. I'll call in for you and say that you're sick.
No, I can't.
Don't be such a pussy.
I could be anyone. I might be a psychotic.
I've met psychotics and you're not. Go.
Memory one.
Who do I speak to?
Harry Masters.
And what's your name?
Mr. Daniel Wolfe. What's your name?
Alice. My name's Alice Ayers.
Thanks. When's it published?
The next year. How come you read it?
Your publisher sent me a manuscript. I read it last night. You kept me up till four.
I'm flattered.
Is your anonymous heroine based on someone real?
She's someone called Alice.
How does she feel about you stealing her life?
Borrowing her life? I'm dedicating the book to her. She's pleased. Do you exhibit?
Next summer.
Portraits?
Yes.
Of who?
Strangers.
How do your strangers feel about you stealing their lives?
Borrowing.
Am I a stranger?
No, you're a job.
You're beautiful.
No, I'm not. Chin up and I'm a scruncher.
You didn't find it obscene?
What?
The book.
No, I thought it was accurate.
About what?
About sex, about love.
In what way?
You read it.
Well, you read it? Till four.
Don't raise your eyebrows, you look smug. Stand up.
But you did like it?
Yes, but I could have liked it.
Any criticisms?
Bad title.
Got a better one?
Really?
Sure.
The Aquarium.
You liked the dirty bit?
Some of it.
You like Aquarium?
Fish are therapeutic.
Hang out in aquariums, do you?
When I can.
Good for picking up strangers?
Photographing strangers. I took my first picture in the one at the London Zoo.
Come here.
Don't kiss strange men.
Neither do I.
Do you and Miss Alice live together?
Yes.
She has one address in her address book, ours under H Home.
I've cut that line.
Why?
Too sentimental. Are you married?
Yes. No. Yes.
Which?
Separated.
Do you have any children?
No.
Would you like some?
Yes, but not today. Would Alice like children?
She's too young. Actually, she's coming to meet me here quite soon.
Why are you wasting her time?
I'm not. I'm grateful to her. She's completely lovable and completely unleavable.
And you don't want someone else to get their dirty hands on her?
Maybe.
Men are crap.
Not all the same.
They're still. Your muse.
You've ruined my life.
Don't go away.
Anna? Alice?
Hi.
Sorry if we're still working.
No, we've just finished.
Was he well behaved?
Reasonably.
Is he photogenic?
I think so.
Did you steal his soul?
Would you like some tea?
No thanks, I've been serving it all day.
Can I use the loo through there? She is beautiful.
Yes, she is. I've got to see.
No.
You're getting all sisterly.
I'm not getting sisterly, I don't want trouble.
Not trouble.
No, take it.
I've got to see.
Tough.
I'm a block of ice. Will you take my photo? I've never been photographed by a professional before, and I'd really appreciate it. I could pay you.
No, I'd like to.
Only if you don't mind.
Why should I?
Because you'll have to go away. We don't want him here while we're working, do we?
No, we don't.
Right. I'll wait in the pub on the corner. Have fun. Thank you. Well, good luck with your exhibition.
Good luck with your book.
Thanks.
So, you have an exhibition.
Only a small one. Take a seat. I read Dan's book.
what happened to him?
Someone younger.
What did he do?
He made money in the city.
We used to get those in the clubs and Wall Street boys.
So these places were quite upmarket.
Some of them, but I prefer the dives.
Why?
The poor are more generous.
I've got a great face. How do you feel about Dan using your life for his book?
None of your fucking business.
When he let me in downstairs, he got this. Look. And I've just listened to your conversation. I don't know what to say. Take my picture. I'm not a thief, Alice. Head up. You look beautiful. Turn to me. Good.
Thank you. I don't even have a computer, I'm a photographer.
Where were you between the hours of 5:45 and 6 o'clock yesterday?
I was at a cafe seeing an acquaintance.
Name?
Alice Ayers.
The nature of your business?
Photographic business. Where were you between those hours?
I was on the net talking to you.
No.
I was talking to someone.
Pretending to be me. You were talking to Daniel Wolfe.
Who?
He's Alice's boyfriend. She told me yesterday he plays around on the net. It's him.
No. I was talking to a woman.
How do you know?
Because, believe me, she was a woman.
Oh, God, I hate you.
She was a woman.
No, she wasn't.
She wasn't, was she?
No.
God, what a cunt! Sorry.
I'm a grown-up. Cunt away.
No, thank you. So this bloke?
Daniel Wolfe.
How do you know him?
I don't know him, really. I took his photo for a book he wrote.
Oh, this leaves without a trace.
It's on its way.
There is justice in this world. What's it called?
The aquarium.
You prick! What are you advertising? Why? Why would he pretend to be you?
He likes me.
Wasn't there a funny way of showing it? Couldn't he just send you flowers? Yeah.
Thanks. What a thing, the internet.
Yes.
Possibility of genuine global communication, the last great democratic medium.
Absolutely, it's the future.
Two boys tossing in cyberspace.
He was a toss. I will say this for him, right. Is he in love with you?
I don't think so, no.
Are you in love with him?
I hardly know him, no.
You're sort of interested.
I think he's interesting.
So, what are you doing?
I'm looking at fish.
Are you all right?
Mm-hmm.
You can tell me.
Because you're a doctor.
Because I'm here. Crying is allowed.
I'm not allowed, thanks anyway.
I'm known for my bedside manner. refugee escaping from the glittering battle. And you are a young woman in London. Right, see? You like it?
No.
You should. What are you so sad about?
Life.
What's that then? What do you reckon, generally?
You want to talk about the art?
Well, yes, I know it's vulgar to discuss the work and an opening of the work. Someone's got to do it, no? Now, serious, what do you think?
It's a lie. It's a bunch of sad strangers photographed beautifully and all the rich fuckers who appreciate art say it's beautiful because it's what they want to see. But the people in the photos are sad and alone, and pictures only make the world seem beautiful. So, the exhibition is reassuring, which makes it a lie. And everyone loves a big, fat lie.
I'm a big, fat liar's boyfriend.
Bastard.
Very.
Alice. So, you're Anna's boyfriend.
Oh, Princess can't kiss a frog.
How long have you been seeing her?
4 months. We're in the first flush of paradise on my nasty Alistair music. Maybe you shouldn't smoke.
Fuck off.
Oh, God, I was just saying things like that.
You want one?
No. Yes. No. Yes. No, no, no. I've given up. Pleasure in self-destruction is the perfect poison. So, Anna tells me you blow through the book. Is it any good?
Of course.
It's about you, isn't it?
Some of me.
Really? What do you leave out?
The truth.
Is he here? Your book?
Yeah, he's talking to your bird.
So, you were a stripper?
Yeah.
When? When first you got that?
You've asked me this before.
Really? When?
2.5 years ago. I was in hospital and you looked at my leg.
Did you remember me?
It was a memorable day. Mm. You didn't really want to stop, but you did. You were offering for after smoke and you gave me a cigarette.
Well, I don't smoke now, what should you?
But you used to go and smoke on the sly.
Yeah, in this little park near the hospital.
Close to this park?
That's the one. And the scar?
Mafia hitman broke my leg.
Really?
Absolutely.
Oh, it doesn't look like a break.
What does it look like?
More like something went into it. A knife, maybe.
When I was 8, some metal from my parents' car went into my leg. And it crashed. And they died. Happy now?
Sorry, it's really none of my business. I'm supposed to be off duty.
It's nice being good.
What about you? I'm seeing my first private patient tomorrow. I'm not a sellout.
Not a sellout.
Thanks. Take care.
I will. You
Do you love him?
very much.
We're not married.
Am I?
Don't. Marry me. Children, everything. You don't want his children, three little stooges in white coats. Don't marry him, marry me. Grow old with me, die with me, wear a battered cardigan on the beach in Bournemouth. Marry me.
I don't know you.
Yes, you do. I couldn't feel what I feel for you unless you felt it too. We're in love. It's not our fault. Stop wasting his time.
I've seen you for a year.
Yes, you have.
Only because you stalked me outside my studio.
I didn't stalk. I lurked. And when I wasn't there, you looked for me.
How do you know if you weren't there?
Because I was there. Lurking from a distance. I'm in love with your work, by the way. It's tragic.
Thanks.
I know this isn't appropriate. I'm going to my father's funeral. Come with me.
Your father died?
It's fine. I hate it. But no, I don't care about that. I care about this. Come with me. Spend a weekend with me, then decide.
I don't want to go to your father's funeral. There's nothing to decide. What about Alice?
She'll survive. I can't be her father anymore. And you want to believe that he's the one, but it's not real. You're scared of this.
There is no this. I love him.
Why?
Any number of reasons.
Well, name one.
He's kind.
Well, don't give me kind. Kind is dull. Kind will kill you. Alice is kind. Even I'm kind. Anyone can be fucking kind. I can't live without you.
You can. You do.
This is not me. I don't do this. All the words are old. There are no new words. I love you.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do. I need you. I can't work. I can't think. I can't breathe. But we are going to die. Please, save me. Look at me. Tell me you're not in love with me.
I'm not in love with you.
You just lied. See me next week, and I'm begging you. I'm your stranger. Jump.
Look out.
Hello, stranger. Tense conversation.
It's hard, sir. Are you spying?
Lovingly observing. With a telescope. You know, he's shorter than his photo.
Photo is a headshot.
Yes, I know, but his head implied a long body. But his head isn't that deceptive.
Deceptive?
Yes, because he's actually got a short body. He's a tiny bugger. I'm gonna have him.
What?
If you came to it in a scrap, I'm gonna have him. Did she tell him to call him Cupid?
No, that's our joke.
You know, I've never worn candy before. I feel like Cinderella's bombs, thank you.
You're such a peasant.
Love it. I had a chat with young Alice.
Oh, fancy her?
Of course. Not as much as you.
Why?
Well, because you're a woman, she's a girl. She's got the moronic beauty of youth, she's got side.
She seems very open to me.
That's because that's what she wants to see. You forget, you're dealing with a clinical observer at the human carnival.
Where am I now?
Oh, yes.
You seem more like a cat who got the cream. You can stop licking yourself, you know.
That's the nastiest thing you've ever said to me.
I'm sorry. That was a horrible thing to say. My family's here and friends. I've got no excuse. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I know you must stop calling you. I met your dad.
I know. He actually said, I like him. He's never said that before about anyone. Well, I adored him. My stepmother thinks you're gorgeous. Lovely hand, she said. Imagine him doing his stitching. Very sensitive.
They didn't think I was beneath you.
No, you're not. You're you, and you're wonderful.
Did you like my films? I loved you.
Your mother's got such a kind face. Mm.
had a drink with Harry. You never have one drink with Harry.
Did you eat? I made sandwiches, no crust.
I'm not hungry.
What?
This will hurt. I've been with Anna. I'm in love with her. We've been seeing each other for a year.
Don't move. I want to remember this moment forever. The first time I walked through that door returning from a business trip to be greeted by my wife. I have, in this moment, become an adult. Thanks for waiting up, you darling goddess. Oh, I missed you. Oh. Jesus, I'm knackered.
Didn't you sleep on the plane?
No, because the one German sleeping next to me was smiling like a Messerschmitt. What's the time?
Midnight.
7. Time with a tricky little fucker. My head's in 2 places, my brain actually hurts.
Do you want some food?
No, I have my scooby snacks on the plane. I need a bath.
Should I run you one?
No. I just have a shower. Are you alright?
Mm-hmm. How's the thing?
Well, as dermatological conferences go, it was a riot.
How was the hotel?
You know, someone told me that all the beautiful people of the Paramount Hotel, the concierge, the bellboys, the bellgirls, did you know this? They're all whores.
Everyone knows that.
I didn't. God, I love New York. What a town. It's a 24-hour pageant called Whatever You Want. They celebrate the sellout. It's a Mardi Gras degradation. Then you come back to Heathrow. First thing you see is this carpet. This unbelievable carpet. What color is the carpet at Heathrow Airport? Yeah, well, they must have laid it to reassure foreigners from a serious country. God, I stink.
Are you alright?
Yes. I don't suppose you fancy a friendly poke.
I just had a bar.
Right. See to myself then in the El Decoration bath.
You chose that bathroom?
Yes, and every time I wash in it, I feel dirty. It's cleaner than I am. It's called attitude. That mirror says, who the fuck are you?
You chose it.
That doesn't mean I like it. You know, we shouldn't have all this.
Are you experiencing bourgeois guilt?
Working class guilt? Why are you dressed in just that bath?
We need some milk.
Right. Are you sure you're okay?
Uh-huh. You?
Yes.
I'm going.
I'm sorry.
Irrelevant. What are you sorry for?
Everything.
Why didn't you tell me before?
Cowardice.
It's because she's clever.
No, it's because she doesn't need.
And you bring her here.
Yes.
And she sits here?
Yes.
Didn't she get married?
She stopped seeing.
Is that when we went to the country? To celebrate our 3rd anniversary?
Yes.
At least have the guts to look in. Did you phone her and beg her to come back when you went on your long, lonely walks?
Yes.
You're a piece of shit.
Deception is brutal. I'm not pretending otherwise.
How? How does it work? How can you do this to someone?
I don't know.
Not good enough. I'm going.
No, wait. It's late. It's not safe.
And it's safe in here?
What about your things?
I don't need things.
But where will you go?
I'll disappear.
The Sultan has returned bearing gifts.
Don't come in!
You know, Alice was at the Paramount Hotel.
What?
They sell these only postcards in the lobby. I bought one to boost your sales. Young Woman London. And I looked for your book at the Museum of Art. It's there. Somebody bloody bought one. It's a student with a ridiculous little beard. He was drooling over your photo on the inside cover. He fancied you. I was so proud of you. You've broken New York.
You're wonderful.
Don't ever forget it.
Change your mind. Please change your mind. Nice to see you. Dan, can I still see you? Answer me.
I can't see you. If I see you, I'll never leave you.
What will you do if I find someone else?
Be jealous.
Do you still fancy me?
Of course I do.
You're lying. I've been you. Hold me. I abuse you, but I bore you.
No, no.
So you did love me.
I'll always love you. You changed my life. I hate her, didn't you?
So why are you?
Because I'm selfish. I think I'll be happier with her.
You won't. You'll miss me. No one will ever love you as much as I do.
I know.
Why is it lonely now? I'm the one who leaves. I'm supposed to leave you. I'm the one who leaves. Make some tea.
Thank you.
here.
On this? We had our first fuck on this! Did you think of me? When? When did you do it here? Question!
This evening.
Oh my God, did you come?
Why are you doing this?
Because I want to know.
Yes, I came.
How many times?
Twice.
How?
First you went down on me and then we fucked.
And who was where?
I was on top and then he fucked me from behind.
Is that when you came the second time?
Why is sex so important?
Become a fucking caveman! Do you touch yourself while he fucks you?
Yes.
Do you wank for him?
Sometimes.
And he does?
We do everything that people who have sex do.
Do you sucking him off?
Yes.
You like his cock?
I love it.
You like it when he comes in your face?
Yes.
What's it taste like?
It tastes like you, but sweeter!
That's the spirit. Thank you. Thank you for your honesty. Now fuck off and die, fucked up slag.
Yes.
Find that look.
Rich.
Close your legs. I don't own strip clubs.
Do you own golf clubs?
No, what I do. Why are you calling yourself Jane?
Because it's my name.
Well, no, it isn't. You're all protecting your identities. There's a girl in there. She calls herself Venus. It's her real name.
Pluto.
Oh, cheeky.
Would you like me to stop being cheeky?
No.
What's your name?
Daniel.
Daniel the dermatologist.
Now see, I never told you my job.
I guess.
You're strong. There's another in there, judging by the scars of a recent patient of Dr. Pitt. She calls herself Cupid. Who's gonna tell her Cupid was a bloke?
Cupid wasn't a bloke, he was a little boy.
I'd like you to tell me your name, please.
Thank you. My name is Jane.
Your real name.
Thank you. My real name is Jane.
Careful.
Thank you. It's still Jane.
I've got another 500 quid here. Why don't I just give you all this money and you tell me what your real name is? Alice?
I promise. My real name is Plain Jane Jones.
Look, I may be rich, but I'm not stupid.
What a shame, Doc. I love rich and stupid.
Look, don't fuck around with me.
I apologize.
Except. All the girls in this hellhole, the pneumatic robots, the coked up baby dolls, and you're no different. You all use stage names to con yourselves. Yeah. Believing you're someone else and you don't feel so ashamed when you show your cunts and assholes to these fucking strangers. I'm just trying to have a conversation.
You're out of cash, Buster.
Look, I paid for the room.
This is extra.
I met you last year.
Wrong girl.
And I touched your face at Anna's opening. I know you're in grief. I know you're destroyed. Just talk to me.
I am.
And talk to me in real life. I didn't know you'd be here. I know who you are. I love your scar. I love everything about you that hurts. She won't even see me. You feel the same. I know you feel the same.
You can't cry here.
Well, just hold me. Let me hold you.
We're not allowed to.
Alice, it's safe. I can look after you.
I don't need looking after.
Everyone needs looking after.
I'm not your revenge fuck.
I'll pay you.
I don't need your money.
You have all my money.
Thank you.
Thank you. Is there some kind of rule?
Right.
Do you have any men in here crying their eyes out?
Occupational hazard.
Have you ever desired a customer?
Yes.
Put me out of my misery. Do you desire me? Because I'm being pretty fucking honest about my feelings for you.
Your feelings?
Well, whatever.
No, I don't desire you.
Thank you. Thank you for your honesty. Next question. Do you think it's possible you could perceive me as something other than a sad slot machine dispensing money?
That's the transaction. You're the customer and I'm the service.
Hey, we're in a strip club. Let's debate sexual politics.
Debate?
You're looking for a smack, gorgeous.
No, you're not.
You are gorgeous.
Thank you.
Will you let me make your affair?
No.
Back to you tomorrow.
Company policy. You give us the money.
What do we get in return?
We're nice to you.
And we can see maybe.
It's beautiful.
I mean, you think you haven't given us anything of yourselves. You think because you don't love us or desire us or even like us that you won.
It's not a war.
But you do give us something of yourself. You give us imagery. And we deal with it what we will. If you could just see 1 minute of our home movies, that shit that slops through our minds every day and string us up by our balls, you really would. You don't understand the territory because you are the territory. I can tell you to strip right now.
Yes, do you want me to?
No. Alice, tell me something true.
Lying is the most fun a girl can have without taking her clothes off. But it's better if you do.
You're cold. You're all cold at heart. What do you have to do to get some intimacy around here?
Maybe next time I'll have worked on my intimacy.
No, tell you what will work. What will work is you'll take off all your clothes right now. And you'll very slowly turn around and bend over and touch the fucking floor for my viewing pleasure.
Is that what you want?
What else could I want? Sign this on one condition. We skip lunch, we go back to my sleek little surgery, and we christen the patient's bed with our final fuck. I know you don't want to, and I know you think I'm sick for asking, but it's what I'm asking for old time's sake. Because I'm obsessed with you. Because I can't get over you unless you... Because I think, on some small level, you owe me for deceiving you so exquisitely. It's for all these reasons I'm begging you to give me your body. Be my whore, and in return, I'll pay you with your liberty. If you do this, I promise I'll not contact you again. You're not a man of my word. I will divorce you and consider the possibility of a friendship. I'll be going to the bar. I assume you still drink vodka tonic.
Any sign of a waiter?
No.
You want some food?
I'm not hungry.
You slept with him, didn't you?
Yes. Sorry.
What do you expect me to do?
Understand, hopefully.
Why didn't you lie to me?
We said we'd always tell each other the truth.
What's so great about the truth? You should try lying for a change. It's the currency of the world.
Dan, I did what he wanted. Now he'll leave us alone. I love you. I didn't give him anything.
But your body?
If Alice came to you, desperate, with all that love still between you, and she said she needed you to want her so she could get over you, you'd do it. And I wouldn't like it either, but I would forgive you. Because it's a mercy fuck. A sympathy fuck. Moral rape. Everyone does it. It's kindness.
No, it's cowardice. You don't have the guts to let him hate you. Did you enjoy it?
No.
So you hated every second of it. Did you come?
No.
Did you fake it?
Yes.
Why?
To make him think I enjoyed it, why do you think?
Well, if you were just a slag, why'd you give him the pleasure of thinking you'd enjoy it?
I don't know, I just did.
Well, you fake it with me?
Yes, yes, I do. I fake it 1 in 3, all right.
Just tell me the truth.
Occasionally, I have faked it. It's not important. You don't make me come. I come, you're in the area providing valiant assistance.
But you make me come.
You're a man, you'd come if the tooth fairy winked at you.
You're late because you've come straight here for being with him.
Yes.
Where was it?
It's new surgery.
Long session?
Dan, please be bigger than jealous. Please be bigger.
Well, what could be bigger than jealousy?
When we're making love, why don't you kiss me? Why don't you like it when I say I love you? I'm on your side. Talk to me.
It hurts. I'm ashamed. I know it's illogical and I do understand, but I hate you. I love you and I don't like other men fucking you. Is that so weird?
No. Yes, it was only sex.
Well, if you can still fuck him, you haven't left him. It's gone. We're not innocent anymore.
Don't stop loving me. I can see it draining out of you. I'm sorry. It was a stupid thing to do. It meant nothing. If you love me enough, you'll forgive me.
Are you testing?
No, Dan, I do understand.
No, he understands. All I can see is him all over you. He's clever, your ex-husband. I almost admire him. She wanted some attention once. I was reading the paper. So she crouched down on the carpet and pissed right in front of me. Isn't that the most charming thing you've ever heard?
Why did you swear eternal love when all you wanted was a fuck?
I didn't just want a fuck. I wanted you.
You wanted excitement. Love bored you.
No. It disappoints me. You know, I think you enjoyed it. It wheedles you into bed, the old jokes, the strange familiarity. I think you had a whale of a time. And the truth is, I'll never know unless I ask him.
Why don't you?
Now.
Vodka time for the lady.
Drink your drink and then we'll go. I'm doing this because I feel guilty and because I pity you. You know that, don't you?
Yes.
Feel good about yourself?
No. I'm sorry.
I didn't do it to hurt you. All about you.
I know. Let's go home. I'll get us a cab.
Where you going?
I don't know.
You know, it's best to be truthful about this sort of thing.
Sign.
I forgive you.
Sign.
Thank you. I have a surprise for you.
Oh, you're full of them.
Wait here.
Lazy on a Sunday afternoon. And you?
I'm meeting Alice.
Oh.
Dan's ex, Alice. She phoned me at the studio this morning. She wants her natives.
Right, right.
You don't go to museums.
Well, the evidence would appear to suggest otherwise.
Are you okay?
Yeah. And you?
Fine. It's your birthday today.
Yes, I know.
I thought of you this morning.
Lucky me.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Present?
Yeah?
What is it?
It's a Newton's cradle.
Oh, who from?
It's from my dad.
From Joe?
It's from Alice. I'm fucking her. I'm fucking Alice. Look, she set us up. I had no idea you were meeting her.
You're old enough to be her ancestor.
Yes, it's disgusting, isn't it?
You should be ashamed.
Oh, I am.
How?
Well, I went to a club and she happened to be there.
A club?
Yes, a club.
You don't go to clubs.
I'm reliving my youth.
Was it a strip club?
You know, I can't remember. Jealous. Oh well.
When did it start?
About a month ago.
Before or after I came to your surgery?
The night before. She made me strip for
her.
I
don't want to know.
Yes, I know. Did you tell your soulmate about that afternoon?
Course.
And how do you take it?
Like a man.
Well, I told you it's best to be truthful.
You're sly.
Am I? You know, you do love your museums. You look like a tourist.
I feel like one. Yeah. It's very easy.
Well, it was easier than loving you. Me and Alice, it's nothing.
Nice nothing?
Very. Look, since we're talking, would you mind having a word with your lawyers? I still haven't received confirmation about divorce. If that's what you still want.
Hi. Do you know each other?
I'll leave you to it.
Good idea. We don't want him here while we're working, do we?
Later, Minx.
How did you get so brutal?
I lived a little.
You're primitive.
Yeah, I am. How's Dan?
Fine.
Did you tell him you were seeing me?
No.
Do you cut off his crusts?
What?
Do you cut off his crusts?
What do you want?
I want my negatives. What's your latest work, Anna?
Derelict buildings.
How nice. The beauty of ugliness.
What are you doing with her?
Everything. I like your bed. You should come round one night and watch your husband blubbering into his pillow. It might help you develop a conscience.
I knew what I'd done.
You know whose big thing at the moment is how upset his family are. Apparently, they are worshipped you and they can't understand where you had to go to ruin everything. You know, he spends hours staring at my arsehole like there's going to be some answer there. Any ideas? Anna? Why don't you go back to him?
And then Dan will go back to you.
Maybe.
Ask him.
I'm not a beggar.
Dan left you. I didn't force him to go.
You made yourself available. Don't weasel out of it.
Screwing Larry was a big mistake.
Yeah, well, everyone screws Larry around here.
You're Dan's little girl. You won't like it.
So don't tell him. I think you owe me that. Oh, she even looks beautiful when she's angry. The perfect one.
Just fucking stop it!
Now it
is. Why come for me now?
I felt strong enough. It's taken 5 months to convince myself that you're not better than me.
It's not a competition.
Yes, it is.
I don't want to fight.
So give in. Why did you do this?
I fell in love with him, Alice.
That's the most stupid expression in the world. I fell in love. As if you had no choice. There's a moment. There's always a moment. I can do this, I can give in to this, or I can resist it. And I don't know when your moment was, but I bet there was one.
Yes, there was.
You didn't fall in love. You gave it to temptation.
You fell in love with him?
No, I chose him. I looked into his briefcase and I saw this sandwich. I said, I will give all my
you still want him? After everything he's done to you? You won't understand.
He buries me. He makes me invisible.
What are you hiding from?
Everything. Everything's a lie, nothing matters.
Too easy, Alice. So cop out of the age.
Yeah, well, you're old!
I'm sorry. I had a choice, and I chose to be selfish. I'm sorry.
Everyone's selfish. I stole Dan from someone else.
Ruth?
Ruth. She went to pieces when he left her.
Did she ever come to see you?
No.
So, what are you going to do? Think. Very nice to you. In bed.
Okay, Dan's better.
Rubbish, at least Larry's there.
Dan's there? In his own quiet way.
Spend a lifetime fucking and never learn how to make love.
I've got this scar on my leg. Larry's mad about it, licks it like a dog.
Yeah, it is.
Dermatology? God knows. This is what we're dealing with. We arrive at our baggage, and for a while they're brilliant, the baggage handlers. We say,
it's your baggage.
They deny all knowledge of it. They're in love. They have none.
Then, just as you're relaxing,
a great big juggernaut arrives
with their baggage. It got held up.
One of the greatest myths men have about women is that we are a pack. Another way to make them feel, but not us. They have dreams.
So do we. You should lower your expectations.
It's easy to say that.
I'm not being patronizing, but you're a child.
You are being patronizing.
And you are a child!
Who's Buster?
Buster? No idea.
He says it in his sleep.
I've got to go.
Good, good to meet
you. Thanks. Do the right thing.
Mother, mommy's boy. Should we stop this? It's over. Accept it. You don't know the first thing about love because you don't understand compromise. You don't even know Alice. Consider her a scar. Where did she get it?
When did you meet Alice?
At Anna's Open. You remember? Look, it's a scar in the shape of a question mark. Solve the mystery.
Well, she got it when her parents' car crashed.
There's a condition called dermatitis olfactor. It's a mental disorder manifested in the skin. The patient manufactures his or her very own skin disease. They pour bleach on themselves. They gouge their skin. They inject themselves with their own piss, sometimes their own shit. They create this disease with the same diabolical attention to detail as the artist of the lover. It looks real, but the source is the deluded self. I think Alice mutilated herself. It's fairly common in children to lose their parents young. They blame themselves. They're disturbed.
Alice is not disturbed.
No, but she is. You were so busy feeling your grand artistic feelings, you never saw what was in front of you. The girl was tender and fragile. She didn't want to be put in a book. She wanted to be loved.
Well, how do you know?
Clinical observation. Don't cry on me.
Sorry. I don't know what to do.
Look, that's it. You want my advice, go back to her.
This should never have me. She's vanished.
No, she hasn't. I found her by accident. She was working in a club. Yes, I saw her naked. No, I didn't fuck her.
You spoke to her?
Yes.
About what?
You. Yes, 1 minute.
How is she?
She loves you beyond comprehension. Your prescription is where she works. Go to her.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Where did you get that?
It's a present. You still pissed about on the net?
Not recently.
You know I wanted to kill you.
I thought you wanted to fuck
me. I did that. I liked your book, by the way.
Thanks. You stand alone.
With Anna. Look, I'm not sucking a literary cock or anything, but I did quite enjoy it, because it was humane, surprisingly. You should write another.
I haven't got the subject.
When I was 9, a policeman pushed me up. Flammable. Still is. Uncle Ted. Nice bloke. Married. Bit of a demon darts player. Don't tell me you haven't got a subject. Every human life is a million stories. I mean, thank God life ends. We never survive it. From the Big Bang to the weary shag, it's the history of the world. Our flesh is ferocious. Our bodies are killers, and our bones will outlast us. You still writing obituaries?
Yes.
Busy?
I was made editor.
Yeah. Why?
Well, the previous editor died. Alcohol poisoning. Sat with him for a week in the hospital.
There you have it. Newton's first law of fuck all. You know, you should never have messed with Anna.
I know. I'm sorry. Thank you.
For what?
Being kind.
You're right. I am kind. Your invoice is in the post. Then, I lied to you. I did fuck Alice. Sorry for having to tell you, but just not big enough to forgive you, Buster.
Don't be scared of flying. I'll protect you.
Well, I'm not. I'm scared of crashing. Did you remember to pack my passport?
Of course, it's with my passport.
And where's that?
In a place where you can't look. No one sees my passport. Hey, when we get on the plane, we'll have been together for 4 years. Happy anniversary, Buster.
I'm going to take my eyes out.
Brush your teeth as well.
What was in my sandwiches?
Tuna.
What color was my apple?
Green.
It was red?
It was green and it was horrible.
What were your first words to me?
Hello, stranger.
Oh, what a slut.
Where had I been?
Clubbing, then the meat market, then the Buried River.
The what?
Well, the Buried River. You went to Blackfriars Bridge to see where the Fleet River comes out, the swimming pig, all that.
You lost the plot, Red Dad.
And you went to that park with the memorial.
Who did you go there with?
My old dead dad.
He was eating an egg sandwich and he had butter on his chin.
How do you remember these things?
Because my head's not full of specky egg-headed rubbish. What was your euphemism?
Reserved. And yours?
Disarmed. What color were the chairs? Black or gray?
No idea.
Trick question. They were blue.
You are a trick question, damsel.
Nice.
Do you remember a doctor?
No, what doctor?
Well, there was a doctor who gave you a cigarette.
No. I haven't been on holiday in forever.
Well, we went to the country.
That doesn't count. You were making sneaky calls to them, which we do not mention.
You think they're happy?
Who?
Anna. Larry.
Couldn't even toss. Go to bed.
I want to fag. How did you manage to give up?
Deep inner strength.
How did you get this?
You know how.
How?
I fell off my bike because I refused to use stabilizers.
Really?
You know how I got in.
Did you do it yourself?
No.
Show me your passport.
No, I look ugly.
When are you going to stop stripping?
Soon.
You're addicted to it.
No, you're not. Pay for this.
Tell me what happened.
Don't. Nothing happened.
But he came to the club?
Loads of men come to the club. You came to the club. The look on your face.
Oh, the look on your face? What a face. What a wig. I love your face. I saw this face, this vision. Then you stepped into the road. Into the moment of my life.
This is the moment of your life.
You were perfect.
I still am.
I know. On the way to the hospital, when you were lolling, I kissed your forehead.
You brute!
The cabbie saw me kiss you. He said, "Is she yours?" I said, "Yes, she's mine." So we came to the club, watched you strip, had a little chat, that was it?
Yes.
You're not trusting me. I love you, you're safe. If you fucked him, you fucked him. I just want to know. Because I want to know everything, because I'm insane. Tell me.
Nothing happened. You were living with someone else.
Well, what are you justifying?
Not justifying anything, I'm just saying.
Well, what are you saying?
I'm not saying anything.
I just want the truth.
I'm telling you the truth!
Well, you and the truth are known strangers. Did you ever give him a present?
No! Where are you going?
Cigarettes.
Everyone's closed.
I'll go to the terminal. I'll be back soon. When I get back, please tell me the truth.
Why?
Because I'm addicted to it. Because without it, we're animals. Trust me, I love you. What?
I don't love you.
Look, I'm sorry.
I've changed the subject. I don't love you anymore.
Well, since when?
Now. Just now. I don't lie and I can't tell the truth, so it's over.
Alice, don't leave me.
I've left. I'm gone. Don't love me. many times. I enjoyed it, I came. I prefer you. Now, go.
I knew that.
You knew?
You told me.
Why?
I wanted you to tell me.
I never would have told you because I knew you'd never forgive me.
I would. I have.
Why did he tell you?
Oh, because he's a bastard.
How could he?
Because he wanted this to happen.
But why test me?
Because I'm an idiot.
Yeah! I would have loved you forever. Now, please go.
Alice, don't do this. Talk to me,
please. I am talking. Fuck off!
I'm sorry. You misunderstand. I didn't mean
yes,
to.
Yes, you did.
I love you.
Where?
What?
Where is this love? I can't see it. I can't touch it. I can't feel it. I can hear it. I can hear some words, but I can't do anything with your easy words.
Listen to me, please.
Whatever you say, it's too late.
Please, don't do this.
It's done. Now, please go. Or I'll call security.
You're not in a strip club. There is no security.
Changes.
You don't change.
So you're seeing anyone?
No. Got a dog.
Really? What sort?
Mongrel. She's a stray. Found her in the street named Colin.
You look fantastic.
Don't stop.
I give you one. Serious.
Fuck off and die, you fucked up slag.
You know, I never told you this, but when I strode into the bathroom that night, I banged my knee on a cast iron tub. The bathroom ambushed me. While you were sobbing in the sitting room, I was hopping around in agony. Mira was having a field day. How's work?
I'm having a break. Taking the dog to the country, we're going for long walks.
Don't become a sad person.
I won't. I'm not.
All your love to a dog.
Well, you didn't want it in the end. There's always someone younger.
How did she die?
I don't know. When he phoned, he said it happened last night in New York. He's flying out today. He wanted to see us before you left.
So they went together?
Split up in January.
You say why?
No.
How did they contact
him? She wrote his name in a passport just next to Kim. You're still in mind. In the event of death. I must remove you. Are you glad you're back at the hospital?
Yeah. Well, Polly said she wouldn't have sex with me unless I gave up private medicine. So what's a man to do?
Do you think families arrange these?
I suppose. It's like leaving flowers at the roadside. People need to remember it. Makes things seem less random. Actually, I hate this memorial.
Why?
Well, it's a sentimental act of a Victorian philanthropist. Remember the dead and forget the living.
You're a pompous bastard.
You are an incurable romantic. Look around the stairs.
Larry, that's horrible.
Alice Ayres, daughter of a bricklayer's labourer, who through intrepid conduct saved three children from a burning house in Union Street Borough at the cost of her own young life. April 24th, 1885. She made herself up. Look, I'm not trying to be callous, but I really do have lots of patience to see. Will you give Dan my apologies? I'm not good with grief.
You're a coward.
Yes, I know.
You do remember me.
Couldn't get away from work. Sorry.
Dan, I'm sorry.
It's fine. You look well.
I am well.
This is where we sat.
Who?
Me and my father. Didn't I tell you?
I'm a wrong girl, you told Alice.
Jane. Her name was Jane Jones. Police felt. They said that someone I knew called Jane had died. I said, there must be some mistake. They had to describe her. No one else to identify the body. She was knocked down by a car, 43rd and Madison. I got to work this morning. Graham said it was on the slab. I went to the fire escape and just cried like a baby. I covered my face. Why did I do that? A man from the treasury had died. Spent all morning writing his obituary. There's no space. There's just not enough space. The phone rang. It was the police. They said there's no record of a parent's death. They said they're trying to trace them. She told me that she fell in love with me because I cut off my crusts. It was only that day. The bread broke in my hands. I ran into Ruth last week. She's married. One kid, another on the way. She married a Spanish poet. She translated his work and fell in love with him. Fell in love with a collection of poems. They were called Solitude. Put these at Blackfriars Bridge. I have to go. I'll miss the plane. Goodbye.
Yes.
Fly, to fly.